You can set up your very own self-hosted VPN server that's secure, private, and fast, and I'll walk you through it step by step, even if you never set up a server before. We'll launch a virtual private server on Comatera running Ubuntu, just $4 a month or totally free with my $100 credit. Then we'll set up WireGuard. Finally, we'll generate VPN profiles for your devices so you can browse the internet privately, staying fully in control of your data without having to trust a commercial VPN provider to protect you. So let's get started. Now, like I mentioned, I'll be using a VPS to host my VPN server because it's easy to access from anywhere. Setting it up at home can get a little tricky, but if you want to self-host there, you can still follow along with a few tweaks. Now, otherwise, go ahead and get your $100 free VPS credits from Comatera, link in the description, and meet me over in your Comatera dashboard. Here's where we're going to spin up our VPS server, and we can do that under My Cloud. And then down here, click on Create New Server. The first thing I'm going to do is pick a zone. Now, this is the physical data center where your server will exist, and this is where your IP address will come from. So choose carefully because all your traffic will appear to come from this IP address when it's assigned to you. So I'm actually currently in Atlanta, so I'm not going to pick that one. Let's pick Miami. And then down here under Choose an Image, we want to pick Ubuntu, and we'll pick the latest 24.04 64-bit version. And then coming down here to the server specs, we want availability for the type. And then because WireGuard is such a lightweight open source program, we really only need one CPU core, 1 gigabyte of RAM, and we can choose up to 20 gigabytes and still have our monthly price of just $4 a month. And we'll move on down here to the networking tab. Now, by default, you get 5 terabytes of traffic per month for your VPS. But if you switch over to the advanced mode, you'll see that you have another option here. So you basically get unlimited traffic, but you're throttled at 50 megabits per second. You still have access to the 10 gigabit port. I'm gonna pick the default 5 terabytes because that is a lot of traffic and I don't think I'll get anywhere near that limit. Coming on down here, let's go ahead and pick a password to log into your server. And then for the name, you could pick anything that you want. I'm just gonna call mine Tony Flow. And then finally, under billing, you have the option to do an hourly billing cycle where you could just get charged a fraction of a penny when it's powered on. But I think the more economical option is to do the monthly billing cycle at just $4 a month. So if you're okay with that, go ahead and click on Create Server. This will take just a few minutes to set up the server, and when it's done, I'll catch back up with you. All right, now that our server is up and running, it has this IP address, and I'm going to copy that to my clipboard. Basically, at this point, you can either use the raw IP address for your VPN server, or if you have a domain name, we can associate the domain name with the IP address. So basically, no matter where you registered your domain name, if you have one, you can follow these steps. It'll slightly differ with the user interface, but the same concept still applies. So basically, we're going to use my domain name, lulanta.org. In here, you'll find something called DNS settings, something like that. Mine in here is called a zone file. And what we're going to do is create a DNS record. The type is going to be A, and you can associate that with your domain name directly, but I'm going to put a subdomain in there called VPN. And then the target is going to be the IP address of your server. So we'll go ahead and confirm that. Okay, our DNS A record has been created, as you can see here, and it's mapping vpn.lulanta.org to the IP address of our server. So let's open up a terminal window if you're on Mac or Linux. If you're on Windows, you can open up a command prompt. And what we're going to do is log into the remote server via SSH. So what that's going to look like is something like this. SSH root, which is the name of the default user for your server, at either your IP address or your domain name. Mine's vpn.lulanta.org. Hit enter. And at this point, you might see the DNS propagation delay if you don't see this message. Just give it a few more minutes and try again. Otherwise, are you sure you want to continue connecting? Type yes, hit enter. And then the password that we created just a minute ago, go ahead and type or paste that in, hit enter. And now we are connected to our remote server in the, my case, Miami data center. So as is always good practice with a new server, let's go ahead and do an apt update. And then as you can see here, there are 87 packages that can be upgraded and we'll follow that up with an apt upgrade. Hit enter. Do you want to continue? Capital Y, hit enter, and we'll let that do its thing. All right, that has finished. And before we go ahead and install WireGuard, I just want to point something out to you. So basically, this is the official WireGuard open source repository. It is at github.com/WireGuard, and you can install this directly on the server. It's a lot more complicated though. So basically there is this community script that this person created that is very popular, has almost 10,000 stars on GitHub. And basically the aim of the project is to make the setup of WireGuard super easy as possible, as it says here. And we're gonna follow these instructions to install WireGuard. So basically down here, line by line, let's go ahead and execute these commands on our server. So we'll do the curl to get this install script. And then we'll change the permissions of that to have an executable. And then finally, we will do .wireguardinstall.sh, hit enter. And basically the next few steps are going to be a wizard to help you with the install process. Basically, for a lot of this, you're gonna keep the default. So unless that's not your IP address, go ahead and hit enter. And then the public interface eth0, that's correct. WireGuard interface name, we'll keep it at the default. And now server WireGuard IP version 4, this is like your internal IP address for your VPN. Each device actually gets its own profile. So we'll talk about that in a little bit, but let's get through this first. So basically IPv6 address, keep the default, the port default. And unless you need to change anything, go ahead and keep all the defaults. Finally, press any key to continue the installation and we'll let that do its thing. Okay, so let's make our first client configuration. This is gonna be for the computer that I'm on right now, my MacBook. So I'm gonna call it Tony's MacBook Pro, hit enter, and it's going to default to an IP version 4 address, which is just 1 incremented to 2. So we'll hit enter, and then same thing for IPv6. And now we have our first client configuration, which is located in this directory. There's a nifty QR code here that you can use if you want to download that. We're going to do that with secure copy in just a second. But basically it says here, WireGuard is running. So let's go ahead, get that client configuration onto your local machine. In this case, like I said, I'm going to be using my desktop computer. If you're on a phone, then maybe you'll scan that QR code. Otherwise, I'm going to exit out of here with exit, and on my local computer, I'm going to go to my desktop, and then, like I said, I'm going to use the scp secure copy command to pull that file from this directory. So basically, let's go ahead and copy that, and we'll do scp, kind of like we're logging into an SSH session root at vpn.lulanta.org, colon, and then the path to the file that we want. And the destination, in this case, we'll just throw that onto the desktop, hit enter, go ahead and type or paste your password, hit enter, and now we have that file on our desktop. And let me prove that to you by minimizing everything. Here it is up here in the upper right-hand corner. Now, the next thing you want to do is to install the WireGuard client onto your local machine. I'm going to go to WireGuard.com/install. And again, depending on what device you're on, pick the appropriate installer. I'm going to pick the one for Mac OS, and that's going to open up the App Store. And I'll go ahead and install that. And then we will open up WireGuard. And the first thing I want to do is to either down here click the plus or import tunnels from file. And we're just going to simply pick that one from our desktop import, and we can allow that. And now before I connect to the VPN server, I just want to show you that this is actually doing what we want it to do. So I'm going to go to a IP location checker. Here we go. My IP location is in Atlanta, Georgia. Now let's go ahead, come back in here and turn on the WireGuard connection. We'll activate that. And it says it is active. So let's minimize that. And now when I refresh the page, we should see my IP location be in Miami. And there you go. My IP address has changed to that of my VPS server. And my IP location is in Miami, Florida. Now, just like with any secure setup, there are a few more steps that you need to take. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to secure your VPS with a firewall. Then after that, I'm going to show you how to create SSH keys and disable both root and password logins. I'll see you over there.